Okay, I have done like 9 hours of grinding apparently in the last 2 days. Good grief. And as a result, I have gained 11 levels. Probably more like 12 as a party average. Just gonna go and stock up quickly. Or apparently, we're gonna have to do this fight first. Yeah, I've been grinding like heck because I think the way I'm going to get the most out of this game is by making it not very hard. My party are now all fully job mastered knight ninjas. So I hand out quite a lot of damage. My healer is an item user with max leveled chemistry because that's the laziest option. I don't expect to need that very much, very often. One thing I can do now, though, is throw bombs at everything. Still can't get over how much the basic battle music sounds like it's out of FF12. That makes you. Oh, no, you're not my item, my healer. Which of these characters is my healer then? I could probably finish this guy with a shuriken, but I've got a million in the bank, so the extra 200 gil doesn't really make that much of a difference. Dual-wield counters are fun. And there you have it. Random encounters do scale with level in this game, but there comes a point where they just fall behind. I'm hoping that I've already. Ah, that would make a lot of sense, Fuzzy. Hi, by the way. It's the same composer as 12 as well. Particularly it being the same composer working with the same. You're in the wrong place. Working with the same. Producer. Now, this is the map most likely to wipe me out, because you can get rid of Chocobos here and Mind Slayers, and it's bad. But this doesn't look like too bad of an enemy set. I don't see any red squid. We are fighting in a storm, though. Do I have throw range? To be honest, I've been more or less ignoring all things Zodiac in this game. Taking a very brute force and ignorance approach. One square short. Yeah, the Zodiac stuff, like a lot of the Bravery and Faith mechanics, has mostly been in... Oh, that must be why that seems randomly far more effective here than it did with that other identical monster. Which map, by your reckoning, is the first tough map of the game? Yeah, that's a pretty reasonable one. That was the first place I had to stop and do a bunch of grinding. I feel like this game really is, like, there's a huge kind of hump to get over early on, difficulty-wise. That's not quite going to be enough to take this one out. Ah, the bloody... Stop dropping through the bridge, cursor, please. Yeah, a mastered ninja is fun times. Which of these am I most scared of? 40, 42, 42. Let's go for the odd one out. I think that's the first time I've seen that enemy do that move. Can I get double counter this time? Yeah. Nice. actually going to use a status removing item. Wait a minute. Hooray! I finally get to Zaland, which is where the outfit with all the throw ammo is. Okay, next place we're actually supposed to go to is this one. You know, several times in the past 10 hours of grinding, I've had to walk twice the length of the country to find a random encounter. As soon as I'm actually going somewhere, 3 show up. It's like the game can tell. I do love it when the Marlboros spawn in pits right in front of me, though. That is very convenient. Finally, a crit that's actually useful for something. You got left. Okay. Apologies for the fact that my computer apparently can't run PSP emulation, even with the sound smoothing patch. Jobs are good. No. What? I don't know this map. Oh, actually, maybe I haven't been to this map before. Do these things have an elemental weakness that the game will tell me about? Nope, I shall just use fire then. Ah, you can actually attack it. Right. Oh, don't tase me. You'll one attack. Attack job. Let's see. I can't get it. Can't attack up that slope. What about this guy? Hooray! Oh God. Well, that works. and because of the weird height mechanics in this game, this throw should be eminently possible. But unfortunately, Eleanor doesn't quite have the stats to one-shot a bomb with a bomb. The sadness of the face. There we go. Right, finally we get to Golland. I do hate going into maps blind. I really prefer the Disgaea system where you deploy after you've seen the map and the layout. This guy looks vaguely familiar, but I don't remember him. This is a cool level, though. So this guy is stealing from thieves, from the sound of it. Maybe I don't know him. The heck was that? Do not steal my stuff. God damn it. That armor isn't cheap, you bastards. Go on, counter-tackle him off the roof. No? Okay. The most laborious possible way of working out something's elemental weakness without actually having to attack it. Let's just see if you can get a throw in from there. Throw does go up some weird angles. Go on, don't miss. Hooray! Should have gone to the other side of this one. There we go. This protecting Oren business is going to be quite difficult, I feel. Because I don't have any way to get out on the rooftop. You there. I think I'm going to be retrying this map because of where Oren deployed. And going the wrong way about getting up on the roof with him. Oh god. Needed to go around the other side of the building. This looks like a rather extreme effect. Rip. Failure. This is why we load save state before every battle. It's not quite my first game over. So the only way up onto the rooftop at all, I guess, is that back corner where that guy's just got up. Didn't even get the counter that time. No fair. Or maybe if Oren stays on that corner, they can't get up to him. That would be helpful. Then I'll only have to worry about this guy. So the 86. Hmm. Not going to be throwing anything at anyone over there from here, so... let's... Is that square? Okay. I hate these camera angles, they're really unhelpful. Give me back my armor! I probably wanted to re-equip the throw items skill for this map. To my chemist, because then he would be able to heal Oren while he's on the roof. Oh, that's not good. If this hits a lot of things, though, it could be. Don't move. Oh, why would you do that? I suppose at least now I can heal him. Jolly good. Can't attack down that, okay. Both of these two thieves are immobilized and disabled. You aren't. This! And now we're back in control of things. Because this is the kind of situation where the leveling really tells. There we go. Second attempt. I'm sure Devin will love the fact that I actually wiped on a map, despite 20 levels of grinding. I wonder if a battle folio is a book that my ninja skill will allow me to throw at enemies. Hmm. What a curious character. Any new gear? Wizardry will have to do until we bothered to trek all the way back to the other castle. Unless they also sell heavy armor here, I suppose, which is a possibility. Well, that's the problem, isn't it? Every time a noble in this starts talking about how commoners have common blood, all the subtlety just goes out the window. Well, not even a parting word. Buy stuff. There we go. Still looking for a move plus two boots item. I'll be quite annoyed if there isn't one. I thought we wouldn't get out of the city without a fight. Very constricting deployment zones. Are we sneaking out? Somebody planning to restrain us? Oh, I recognize this. It's a good localization, this. most of the time. Dun, dun, dun. No fictional cleric whose rank was confessor has ever been good news. Did we murder... Oh, Cardinal Delacroix became the first Esper that we fought, I think. I only have to kill that guy. Okay. Where are my dudes? Ah, there are my dudes. I'm guessing if I run in with Ramza, I probably can't do that much damage in a single turn. Let's get out of the line of fire. What's my sister going to do? And those are monks who are usually bad news. Good, she's out of harm's way. Ah, not quite in throw range. I bet you can get in throw range. Something. But I don't necessarily want to force it, because I don't want my squad getting split up too much. Yeah, so I could have gone up onto the rail, but then I would have been a bit exposed. Oh, nice. It's all the effects, including re-raise. Alright, with Ramza, I will be a bit pushy then. What's that monk casting? What can monks spend time casting? Or maybe it's just defending. There, you're unlikely to be able to attack the monk. I can throw something. Dang. And somewhere down here, I have some remedies. Which may not do the trick, but we'll see. Yeah. No, Alma, stay back. Why didn't the knight attack me? Don't block. Thank you. Good. Oops, lazy. Go on, get both hits. Good. We're winning. That's a lot of healing. I wish I hadn't moved Rama so far out of the way, you know? I think I should just have him wait. No counter, weak. That's not good. What? This guy seriously just blocked me 4 times. I am displeased. I managed to do some damage to him at least. That's more like it. Okay, one more hit should do it. Still very little information about the what the actual content of this religion is supposed to be, that we're all supposed to be following, and that I'm thus committing heresy against. Which is interesting, because it casts the authority that we transgressed against as purely the bodies and persons of the clerics. It's quite cynical. So that's what's sending us to Aubonne. There's a nice little moment there where, as Ramza got emphatic, the sister backed up. Just a little reminder of how intimidating a presence Ramza must be. I don't actually need to check that at all. Apparently I can still use the shop. Right. Now, from what I gather, the Aubonne Monastery sequence is one of those that you're supposed to make a whole bunch of backup saves before going into. So, never let it be said I'm not thorough. Is this going to be a dungeon? This game has dungeons? Right. Right, so it's a faction of the church. This is a very straightforward chunk of exposition for such a complex problem. Oddly specific instructions. This one particular C, not just any C. So, we're using one of these files as our actual. Save. At least I get to deploy my full squad. Let's see what awaits us.
Hello?
Hello.
Hi.
How are you doing, Sam?
Doing alright. How are you doing?
I'm alright. I'm munching face due to being ridiculously overleveled. It's quite satisfying.
Oh, that's kind of different to how I felt in this game.
I got over the initial hump, and then grinding's actually just really chill.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
So, generally, how are you feeling about this game?
I'm enjoying it a lot.
Really?
Yeah, I think I'm not finding the narrative quite as deep as popular opinion holds it to be, but it's pretty good.
I just remember seeing some like long feature about how this is all about privilege.
Mm-hmm. I think I read the same thing.
Yeah.
And it kind of is, but it's not the,
Oh dear.
Oh? You alright?
Yeah, no, just, kitten snuck in.
Ah.
I thought the door was closed.
Who are you? It's Jimmy. It's okay. Are you time mages? Yes. You're going to be a problem. That's a dragoon. I need to watch out for them too, because they have jump and will get at me. Don't wait.
Yeah, it's... This is probably a game... Well, every game you seem to play is a game I want to get around to eventually.
Yep.
Except Kingdom Hearts 2, which is one I already played.
Yes. I mean, there are loads of games that we don't play that I want to get around to.
Well, yeah, because that's the games you want to get around to, not the games you're playing.
That I wish we could find time to do for the podcast, but, like, we only have 12 months in a year.
Yeah, like, I wouldn't imagine like you guys quickly doing a Persona episode or Persona 3 or 4.
I'm doing something else for Persona 3 starting soon.
Oh.
Gonna do a let's play of that.
Ooh, that'd be interesting. I like that game.
I hope it's better than Persona 4. Persona 4 I watched a let's play of and got quite angry about.
I played Persona 4 and loved it, but...
Bits of it are great. Like, all the stuff with the TVs is really cool, but there's some broader character stuff that rankled, particularly with Kanji and Naoto.
Yeah, no, that stuff is not great, but...
it's inevitable.
Ooh.
Now, do I finish this thief off? Yeah, I'm going to finish the thief off, because otherwise I'll be doing the rest of this area with missing bits of armour, because that's how thievery works. It's not just permadeath, it's all... Sorry?
So if a thief steals something from you...
gone for good, you can't get it back, unless you steal it off them. It's
well, good thing money's not an issue in this game.
Well, it's not an issue for me in this game.
Oh really? Is one of the others having an issue with it?
I don't know. Like, I'd be very surprised if money's ever an issue, but like, I have 1.2 million gil in the bank because grinding.
Well, the thing is, I didn't really grind, and I never got to a point where like I felt strapped for cash.
I think early on it can be possible, but only early on.
Well, it's kind of... I like literally bought the best armor I could for everyone at every possible moment, and
yeah,
and like bought as many items as I needed to.
Mm-hmm. I've got the full stock of 99 bombs for everyone.
So pretty much, you've kind of just like worked this game out.
I hope so. I mean, I think I'm going to run into some difficulties later on. Because what I've got at the moment, what I'm using, is a very one-size-fits-all strategy. And there are going to be sizes it doesn't fit.
From what I understand, the game does not get hard at the end.
I think there are going to be some areas that are a bit tricky. Some bosses. Because the one actual like boss that I fought... because of its use of status effects, was pretty mean.
Yeah.
Where are you going?
Interesting, like, any strategy RPG having a boss, because it's an odd sort of structure, I suppose, that they don't quite feel as necessary.
Yeah, I mean, like, there's bosses and bosses. It's had kind of climactic levels several times,
yeah.
But there's only been one set piece where you only fought a single dude.
Yeah. Like, the way Fire Emblem has it is there's pretty much any sort of boss is just a stronger dude with a few more spells up his hand.
Yeah. Stop blocking me, you bastards. One thing that's nice with doing all the grinding is I've started to get used to all the menus, so it's feeling a lot less sluggish to play.
Yeah,
that's
I think
quite important.
That's a good thing.
Also, the ninja dual wield skill is ridiculously good. Just double all your attacks. The most ridiculous thing I've seen it do is works with the... you know, the knights have the skills like rend power and reduce stats and stuff.
Yeah. So you can double rend.
You can double rend. You can double rend power, which gives you... double the rending effect. And rend usually reduces power by 3. That means you get a power reduction of 6. In this game, 9 is high power. So you can reduce people to power 3.
That is really...
silly is the word. there was a battle trophy and I didn't see what it was. Never mind. Not something I've needed to pay attention to thus far. And I made quite a lot of safety saves just before you showed up. Because You can't get out of this sequence.
If you were streaming on some other servers, I could have gone back and checked that.
Yeah. Did anything actually get destroyed? No. Jolly good. And as ever, save state before every map. Oh wow, this looks like fun.
So how do you feel about the way maps are designed in this then?
I'm not enjoying the map design. It's finicky and irritating. I have to defeat that guy all the way over there. Presumably I have to go through everything else.
Mages?
Yeah.
According to Becky, they're not in this game.
They're in this game. They keep blowing me up, but...
Because you can't... You refuse to use mages.
If it wouldn't actually avail me anything to use mages, because I've used them badly. There's a summoner over there I probably need to take care of, and then we've got archers... Probably putting the lie to the idea that this environment has a roof. Let's send Ramza after the summoner.
Well, it looks like a library, doesn't it?
It's the vaults under the temple. Or monastery.
I don't know, I never got this far.
That's because you didn't grind enough.
Nah, it's because I couldn't be bothered. I never got stuck, it was just I couldn't be bothered.
Sam, what are we going to do with you?
Sometimes I finish things.
Lies. I roll to disbelieve.
I finished Dark Souls 3.
Those are short games, though. They don't count.
It's like 27 hours. That's the shortest one.
Yeah, like I say, short games.
The first one took me 50 hours.
Yeah, short.
What's not a short game?
Reminder that my first Final Fantasy was FF12, and my first playthrough of FF12 took me 186 hours.
Yeah, that's really long. I don't expect you to put 186 hours into every video game.
And rightly so, because that would be horrendous.
That's like reading, I don't know, War and Peace and declaring every other book to be short.
Well, War and Peace is actually relatively short by the standards of some fiction sequences that I've read. I really like long stories.
Oh, Jesus Christ. No, I don't read enough fiction.
You should read some more fiction then.
Yeah.
Please don't turn us all to stone. That would suck.
I just bought a book in a charity shop the other day.
Good. Steps in the right direction. I'm not happy with archers that can fire over bookcases like that. That's a bit ridiculous.
Well, they just have... Somehow, someone just knows.
Mm-hmm.
Like, knows. Oh, there's someone there, isn't there?
Mm-hmm.
Like, every archer just is Robin Hood.
Mm-hmm. Is Ramza actually going to survive this? Because that was a hell of a lot of damage, and he's very isolated from any healing.
This map seems geared in favour of ranged attackers.
Yeah, probably. Let's see. I don't want to send anyone after you. You can go after this guy. I'm starting to think I could have left the summoner completely alone, you know. Yes, that's right. You're the one who can't do anything at range. That takes care of the summoner, at least. Who theoretically was the scary one. Ooh. Yeah, I think I've got this under control. Don't throw the bomb at your own dude. That would be bad.
No, don't do that. Why would you do that?
Slip of the cursor. That would be why.
Ever.
Mm-hmm. Lol, potion healing. Only scrubs like me do that, AI. And I managed to draw one of the archers off, so Ramza is going to survive. I don't think the church does believe this, you know. I keep wanting to call this guy Isildur, and that's not actually his name, but his name is very close to Isildur. Isildur!
Isildur!
Mm-hmm. I mean, the crown is rotten and the nobility are corrupt, but also the church is rotten and corrupt, and we have had ample demonstration of that thus far. Go on, counter. Isildur. Yeah, I don't feel bad about remembering this guy's name is Isildur.
It's like an anagram of Isildur, right?
It's one letter short, it doesn't have an R.
I was making a joke.
Why can every named character bad guy teleport? This is completely unexplained. But it's ubiquitous. It's the most transparent this is a video game thing that this game does.
I feel that maybe that is, like, it's down to technical limitations and not them just trying to find some hacky way of them just running across the map and make it might look a bit stupid.
Mm. There's one more fight to go.
Oh, well, you've put a lot of time into this, haven't you?
40 hours so far.
Oh. I've only put about 10.
Well, that's why you didn't get to any of the good stuff then.
I think I got to the kid with the gun.
Oh, him. He's quite annoying.
Is he?
Yeah, also, his gun stayed with him. After he left the party, I somehow still had his gun. And, Well, this is surprising. Alma didn't succeed at hiding. I still had his gun, but it got broken in a map where... it was equipped to someone who got confused. No, who was attacked by one of my confused dudes. And confusion, they used random moves, they used red weapon. Rip gun.
Oh.
And here we have Vigraf, who we've already killed once. Sorry,
is it Vigraf? I think with tactical RPGs, because I feel like I get a headache each time I play this game.
It's I can see that it's not undemanding.
But then I don't mind Fire Emblem, the newer one. Actually, the newer one comes out tomorrow over here.
That's a lot of damage to start the battle with.
They put out a version of Fire Emblem Fates now where you can just buy all three without the special edition, and it's 70 quid.
That's alright.
I think it feels weird because the way they've branded it makes it feel like it would be one game, but they're charging more for it. But from as I understand, they play completely differently. I did see someone describe. I thought it was interesting. I heard someone describe the last Fire Emblem, not the current one, but Awakening.
Yeah.
As simultaneously the hardest or easiest Fire Emblem, depending on how you play it.
Possibly. I mean, they've done quite a lot to add kind of difficulty variability to them. What I understand. The only one I've played is the GameCube one.
Oh, yeah. I heard that one's kind of really hard.
Yeah, I didn't finish it. Oh crap! I don't know. Is that it? But he had like a whole posse with him. Okay.
Are you serious? Is this the match over?
Yeah. All I had to do was kill Vigoroth, and like. All that took was two turns. Okay. I'll take it. I got out of the monastery. I like that it made me fight a battle on the like on the way out as well though. That was pretty good.
Yeah. Well. Fight.
It could have been a fight.
Probably would have been a fight if I was playing.
Well, I have stacked for that kind of scenario where there's one enemy who can be very quickly dispensed with. But this is... So, the intro to the game is somebody being abducted at this monastery who Ramza was supposed to be protecting. That scene then recurs at the start of Chapter 2, because it's the inciting incident of Chapter 2, and now we're back at the same monastery and someone else is being kidnapped who Ramza's supposed to be protecting. There's a motif forming here.
Thinking back to the previous battle. Did you ever see The Avengers?
No.
Oh. Do you have a plan to?
Not really.
Ah, well, there's this whole kind of build-up with the villain Loki.
Mm-hmm.
Where he's all-controlling, he's kind of all-powerful, and he's standing in front of the Hulk. Talking about how much of a god he is.
Oh, is this the Hulk smash puny god thing? Yeah, I've seen memes.
Yeah.
You could have if it was a meme, you could assume that I had some familiarity with it.
I don't think I've seen it much as a meme, actually.
Like a full-on meme, but like there were lots of references to it.
Oh yeah, but yeah, that's basically
meme
what
in the more
did.
General sense.
Yeah, or meme in the actual. Sense or just I don't know what the actual sense of meme is. I haven't read up on it too much.
So now the Godstone is talking to, I can't actually tell whether it's talking to Vigoroth or Ramza here, but I guess I'm about to fight a god. Oh hey, it's Belias. It's the first summon from FF12. You can tell he's speaking old-fashioned because there are random apostrophes.
the sort of faux old English.
Mm-hmm.
God, it's like I either like love or hate faux Shakespearean dialogue.
This game's been pretty good for it so far.
I like it in the Dragon Quest context, because that game is stupid anyway. Well, it's only like the first few on the NES. There's Dragon Warrior, where it's probably relocalized into more normal English now. Oh, the Dragon Quest localization style is really strange. Because every nationality has its own accent.
Ah.
And that's written phonetically.
Okay, so we just got given a book with all the secrets in, which we're not going to read, apparently. But I made it out of the monastery! Yay! I'm presumably now going to spend some time reading the book. Maybe?
I've been playing Final Fantasy X. That's a game I've already finished, and I'm just playing it.
It's a good game.
It is a very good game. The PC version is very good.
That's good to know. Does it run okay?
It runs good on my machine. It does have a 30 FPS lock, but that's not a big deal for that sort of game.
No. Ooh, sorry. Excuse me.
But yeah, it's got a lot of nice convenience features. Well, not a lot, but a few.
Yeah.
You can turn off random encounters.
I hate that. It's just, that so misunderstands what random encounters are there to do, but
I think past a certain point, but there are actually, I feel, points in Final Fantasy X towards the end where they don't serve a good purpose.
Maybe. What about artifacts? Let's see what the scriptures say.
And I think, and it is still a sort of, like, it's not an obvious feature. But, like, for someone who's kind of already played the game and is probably going to grind heavily at certain points, or, like, be powerful, because I'm intending to try and do some super bosses, just having to, like, sit through random encounters that I'm either just going to mash X to just sort of get through quickly with no actual gain from it is kind of not really good.
So, I'm checking the scriptures, and it's talking about what it's like to read them, but not what they say. This is not useful.
What else does it have? It has double speed and quadruple speed.
I don't see how that helps in FF10, really. I suppose you run faster.
The battles move faster as well.
But, like, you still take the same time over your turns, because, like, the battle animations are generally pretty short.
Yeah, but they're even faster now. It's fast enough that the fanfare still plays when you exit the battle.
Sounded to the Libram Pin by the...
No, it's not a good way to play the game properly, but, like, it was mostly because I'd recently played through another system or something. And I just wanted to get through, like, the first part a bit faster.
Right, so now we're actually getting to the content. There was this saint who we've been lied to about. And I think all we know about the saint prior to this is that they worked with the Zodiac Braves to bring some sort of stability against invaders from another world or something.
I'm going to be back in a bit.
I'll possibly still be going. Enjoy food.
Yeah. Alright. See you in a bit.
See you in a bit. Ben! St. George. was Child of the Gods. Right, so we've got a cyclical history thing going on, and Zodiac Braves. So this is the second. This current screen is referring to the second coming of the Zodiac Braves. Presumably, we're on to the third at the moment. Or maybe not the second, but. Many times since. So this is written by Judas, basically. And this is recent enough that the gallows have the same name, because we've been to the Golgolida gallows. That's a hard phrase to say. The Golgolida gallows. They were a level where we rescued the princess once. Wait. None of that is the... How are we still not to the content of the friggin' scripture? What the hell, game? So the book assures us of its own truth. Church, blah, blah, blah. So the religion is false. And now the scholar is being criticized for loving knowledge more than politics, I guess. Right, okay. Everything is optimal. And now, presumably that's the castle, which is the second place where I need lots of safety saves. So, let's get started.
So here you are. They've been searching high and low for you. I do hope this day finds your Royal Highness in better spirits than those past.
Do not mock me! Please. I could not bear it.
That was cruel of me. I'm sorry.
What do you mean to do with me? I am not Ovelia. There can be no value in holding me. No value even in my living.
You're right. You are not the Princess Ovelia. We do not even know your rightful name.
You're not helping.
Whether even you be highborn or low.
I had often wondered, of the royal family, why must I alone be confined to a remote monastery, so far removed from the seat of our crown? Even this I thought a burden light enough, if it meant the kingdom would know peace. I played my part. Still, Ivalice runs red with blood. All this suffering and solitude. For what?
Poor Ovelia. Sad face.
It has been the same for me.
Oh, shut up, Delita.
I was given the wardrobe of a nobleman, and so I played the part. A puppet ever dancing for the amusement of patrons unseen. This wretched world does not reward endeavor. It is the patron and his troop who are receipt. Maggots grown fat on endeavor's course. Most men but play the part they're given. Most live and die not knowing they play a part at all. But I am past all that now. I am their unwitting puppet. No more! No more. I will exact from them the price of their gluttonous feast!
Something, something, Bernie, bro.
What is it you plan to do to them?
I will burn down this kingdom, and from its ashes build for you a new one, a kingdom worthy of you. I will show you a world where your light will outshine the sun, a world that will know no darkness.
No, you won't.
And you will have no more need of tears.
Such a world, is it possible?
I will not fail you in this. On Titra's soul, I swear it to you. Dry your tears.
If that turns into a romance, I'm going to be very annoyed, because there's absolutely nothing to back it up. Yay, random encounters! Oh, maybe this isn't a random encounter. Those are some big beasts chasing this dude.
You'll never be able to outrun them. It's deer you're after. I'll feed you a length of iron.
Nice hat. Behemoth used Rend Sword. Good job Bramza has been stocking up on all those ninja throw skills. Also, why the heck was that a cutscene? These have about 200 health each, but they're only level 17. Any elemental weakness? No. At least they make nice big targets, so they're easy to hit. Okay, one down. And that was a handy crit. Oh, you don't have throw, damn it. Anyway, amidst all this plot and drama, suddenly, for some reason, we have to fight a bunch of behemoths. I like that their corpses are just tails. Where are my behemoth steaks? That won't quite take that one out, so focus on all we can deal with. Whoa! Where the hell did that much damage come from? Oh, you're the, like, extra tough one. Okay. You shall trouble me no more! Still missing disguise, counter counters, and counter counter counters. Counter, nice. Really? Effective. That's the kind of map that makes me very glad for all that grinding I've done, though. Oh! Thank you, Ninjaro. The main character from FFT Advance 2. For some reason. Clearly, FFT Advance 2 is a rather less serious piece of work than this one. Which chocobo shall I chuck this time? Oh, apparently Mustadio's still with me. Whoops. I don't think a level 1 black chocobo is going to be any use. Right, let us try again to reach the castle. I should probably have saved there, shouldn't I? It's just a gang of thieves? Oh, they're deserters. That's complicated. it didn't have to be like this, guys. And with this many thieves, they're going to be really awkward to fight as well. Maybe. This map is awkward. Here's the enemy room. Yes. Oh, that's annoying. Well, I guess it means more XP. A trivial amount more XP, but more XP nevertheless. Don't steal my hat!
Boo!
Ah! That was mean. Don't do that.
Did that actually work?
I genuinely jumped. Please don't do that again.
Aw. Jackson did that to me once. When I would just hover about in the general voice chat.
You probably deserved it. Wait, this dude is called Zell.
Zell Dinked?
Probably not, but you never know with this game.
It's such an odd surname.
Hmm. It's not the only Final Fantasy character with an odd surname.
I know, but it's just an odd one to pronounce.
Hmm.
Like, I think the thing about a lot of surnames in Final Fantasy is usually you can pronounce them. Well, most of them.
Sometimes.
Unless they're probably named after some, like, foreign philosopher or something, most people just tend to not be able to pronounce them, probably including myself.
Right, I've got five dudes, and I need to have five successful attacks. You won't be able to get any closer, so you'd better attack this one. There we go. So that's two encounters now that have basically been random encounters, but that were set pieces.
It seems to be the distinction between whether it's monsters or people.
Well, while you were away, there was the fight. I don't know if you saw, I don't know if you were watching, there was a fight.
No, I wasn't watching, I was in a different room.
I rescued a monster hunter from some behemoths.
Who?
Oh, it's is that
it behemoth
guy.
Or behemoth kind of thing, or is that just a...
I've always said behemoth. I think behemoth is the American population.
Hmm. Like the thing of Roth or Wrath.
So that's nice. Here's a character who's actually decided to be nice to us rather than randomly violent.
I'm just gonna look through all the Final Fantasy X achievements.
Oh, good grief.
See what there are. See if I could name one and see what you could guess it's for. One called Lightning Dancer.
That's for getting Lulu's ultimate weapon.
It's for dodging 200 lightning strikes and obtaining the reward.
Yeah.
Sphere Master, that one's probably a bit obvious.
I don't know, there are a few different possibilities. It could be completing the sphere grid, it could be getting all the jet spheres.
Completing a sphere grid for one character.
Right, yeah.
Master Linguist.
All the Albed spheres.
Yep. Perseverance.
Penance?
Yep, defeat penance.
Good luck with that.
Yeah. And then there's all these 10-2 achievements that I don't know because I haven't actually played much of 10-2.
10-2's a strange experience to play.
That game seems incredibly divisive.
I think it's good. But I, it it's not one that you can have a non-nuanced opinion of.
I've seen plenty. I've not really seen a nuanced opinion on the game. It's mostly just been, I love this game, or you, I hate this game.
Mm-hmm. That's pretty much the problem. All those opinions are wrong.
The true opinion lies somewhere in the middle.
Pretty much. Blimey, that's 2 hours already. This chapter is a lot longer than the previous one.
Oof.
Even with the V-Graf fight having been so quick. Weird thing is, I think they're the same number of forced encounters.
If I've made any weird noises there, I'm just searching my room for jelly beans.
An important quest.
I found them.
Hooray! Now I want jelly beans. Damn you. I have wine gums.
I've not had wine gums for a long time. I don't think I can have them.
Oh, why not?
They might have gelatin in them.
Probably.
Yeah.
Certainly
I'm one of those people. I don't eat meat or anything that comes from an animal.
Fair enough.
Like, well, not like, but I mean, like, is part of an animal. I'm fine with milk and cheese and stuff. But yeah, I'm not prepared to answer questions about it either because people ask the same ones.
It's fair enough. At least you're in. Burnt down our entire village. So, now we're being introduced to two new random characters who apparently have beef with a third new random character that we know nothing about.
Just in the sake of, I'm going to mute myself for a moment because otherwise there's been a load of packet rustling.
Yes, please do. Hooray, another protect somebody fight.
Oh boy.
At least the deployment's relatively kind here, or maybe not.
Oh, I got the sermon one first.
Now you're just taunting me.
Oh, what's this? Have you not had a cinnamon jelly bean before?
I just don't want to hear you talking about them while I can't eat because I'm streaming.
No, but have you had one?
Maybe.
Because it's not like, oh, it's a little bit of cinnamon. No, it is full on, like, eating a bit of cinnamon.
Fun, fun, fun.
Like, it's the prop. It feels like the whole thing is just packed with cinnamon. It's proper spicy.
Good, good.
So it's really fun to fool people with the thing. Hey, there's a strawberry one. Okay, cool. Ah!
That's just cruel. Don't do that. I mean, I'm partial to the taste of strong cinnamon. Have you ever had cinnamon Tic Tacs?
No, I never have.
They're violent. It's amazing.
I basically, like, a long time ago, told my mother that I was into the cinnamon cereal. Like, it was like cinnamon. It's curiously cinnamon now, isn't it? It used to be cinnamon Graham's, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I told her I was into that, and she kept buying loads and loads of boxes. And now I can't eat cinnamon cereal anymore because I've just had too much.
That stuff's like the really sweet end of
yeah
of cinnamon, though. That's perfect. Instead of leaving a corpse that I couldn't stand on, he teleported away. So now I can get through and start work on these ninjas. Because otherwise they will fuck me up. They're still going to fuck me up if they dodge like that.
I dropped a jelly bean and I don't know where it is.
That's a tragedy. Whenever there are two...
Especially when you've got small animals that have put everything in their mouths.
Yes. Whenever there are two tiles on top of one another, after you rest on the tile on one tile for a little while, it jumps to the other tile, and it's always jumping to the wrong tile. Maddening. I should probably have used my healer to heal this guy I'm supposed to be protecting. That would have been a possible thing to do. I like that this guy just did, like, what? How did I just get crit for 240? That's not okay.
There needs to be, like, a proper jelly bean shop where you could do, like, pick between the different flavours.
I mean, there are sweet shops around that have things like that.
Well, yeah, they're called pick and mix.
No, I mean, like, specifically for jelly beans.
I know, but... I want to see if I can just, like, go on, like, because I like Jelly Belly, those are the ones I like.
Those are pretty good.
And Jelly Bean Company. And Jelly Belly's the ones that do, like, the Bertie Bott's ones.
Mm-hmm.
As well.
This is awkward. Do you need healing? No, you're probably right.
Can I just buy... Oh, you can just buy, like, single flavours in a big bag. Oh, yep. Yeah, no, you can, because I've seen those things in shops before, mm-hmm. Actually, yeah.
And specially curated selections of flavours as well.
Yeah. I've got a small box of... Have you ever seen the Bean Boozled jelly beans?
No.
Basically what the concept is every colour can be one of two flavours.
That's a bad idea.
A normal one or a really nasty one.
Harry Potter has a fucking lot to answer for, alright? That is not okay, sweet design.
So, you could either have one that's Tutti Frutti, or it could be Stinky Socks. One that's Lime, or Lawn Clippings. Berry Blue.
Enabling kids to be dicks to one another is what this is.
Chocolate Pudding. Or canned dog food. Yeah, no, this is... I have the packet still in the wrapping because I just don't want to... Like, because the way I eat jelly beans is like... I sometimes just pick a few, a small handful and just shove them in. And see what I get.
Mm-hmm. It's the right way to go about eating jelly beans when they haven't been designed by monsters.
God, imagine just eating all those flavours at once, because, like, if you get... The thing about jelly beans, I find, like, the proper packs, is that mixing a few flavours can either produce something really good or just something really strange.
I mean, it usually just produces sugar, which is all I really want from my confectionery anyway.
Now, sometimes I feel like, with a few of them, it kind of brings, like a perfumey kind of taste. With enough.
Anyway, I have saved this, I think, woman whose brother was abusing her and requiring her to stay in the service of a man who the game hinted had raped her. She didn't say specifically what he'd done to her, but he'd done something horrible to her. that's good. Her saying that the honor of his name is trite. Oh, and the brother's back. I mean, I literally killed you. I reduced your hit points to zero. Wait, he's a frog?
A frog?
Well, he's a frog.
It's a Final Fantasy game. People get turned into frogs all the time, right?
They did in this period. Why have you an exploding frog, no less? Is a sentence I wasn't expecting to say during Final Fantasy Tactics streams. Oh, this is getting us back to Deleter again. Welp. Surprise ninjas. Lol, the princess has tackle now.
Tackle?
Uh-huh. I think it was Hallowed Bolt was the best of these.
What are you playing as Deleter now?
Yeah, there are... Oh shit, I just Hallowed Bolted the princess. That was a mistake. Whoops. I might need to repeat this battle.
So is it just to like random chapters with you playing as him then?
Yeah, every so often there's a battle where you play as Deleter.
I like that.
It's a nice touch, I guess. It's very like all the scenes with the judges in FF12.
I just think it's a cool... I don't know, I just like the idea of games where suddenly you're just a different character somewhere else. Where it's not, like, told to you from the start. I don't know, that's a silly thing, but...
Something that is kind of I think a Matsuno thing is stories that are bigger than one character. And this is definitely that. It has too many characters, and it's hard to keep track of. But...
Did you ever play Vagrant Story?
I haven't yet, I need to.
I hear the gameplay's weird.
Probably. Again, it's a Matsuno game.
Has like all these systems around crafting loads of weapons that like, you have to, sometimes it sounds like you have to craft specific weapons for certain situations. And from what I heard, the game was about 10 hours long in playtesting.
Yeah.
So they decided to double the length of the game.
Hmm. If it's only 20 hours, I might find time to play that this summer then.
Yeah. But apparently it really does show that it's been stretched out. But it was interesting because I went back and read some old like coverage from when that game came out. Mm-hmm. And it's interesting how a lot of like, even though it's kind of like, it is an RPG, it's a dungeon, it's like you go through dungeons essentially.
Yeah.
But a lot of comparisons were to Metal Gear Solid. Just because of how, because of the presentation. Because that's kind of like, I suppose it's early enough with that sort of regard that like, holy shit, you've got so many chocobos.
I have an entire army of chocobos. Basically, I saved the chocobo in the mission where you save a chocobo. And it just sits in your back party and breeds.
I told you this.
Oh, that's right, that was you.
Yeah.
And it will breed up to the limit of your capacity. I had more chocobos, but I've had to start letting them go because other characters are joining my party.
Yeah.
Not that I'm using the other characters, because they're underleveled relative to my party.
I have a feeling like some other Final Fantasy game is just going to be suddenly put on Steam, because like, there's been 2 months in a row where just suddenly a Final Fantasy game is on Steam now.
Oh, and now we have a bunch of spirits of the previous war.
Ooh.
That can teleport. I mean, pretty much the only things missing from Steam now are like FF12 and some of the handheld stuff, like the compilation of FF7 stuff.
Well, based off the stuff they've ported a lot, Final Fantasy Tactics has been ported a fair few times.
Actually, it might well be FFT. Except, no, it won't be FFT, because there's just no way they're ever actually going to release any of the Matsuno games.
I think the Android port wasn't that long ago.
Of Tactics?
Yeah. Huh.
Maybe we will see FF12 eventually. I still don't really believe it.
Yeah, the Android port was last year.
Go figure. No time magic.
But I think 1 and 2 aren't on there either.
On Steam?
Yeah.
At all? It'd probably be then.
Yeah, because I think, yeah, I'm just looking. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 are all there.
And the entire 13 trilogy is now on.
Yeah, 13 trilogy and 14.
Mm-hmm. Is Type 0 on Steam?
Yes, it is.
Yep. So... I mean, I suppose it could be like Crisis Core. I'd really appreciate it.
That game isn't even on PlayStation Network.
It's true.
Because of one piece of music.
Really?
Yeah, that's it.
Is it a copyright thing then?
It is, from the sounds of it. Like, they've basically only licensed the music for the game, but they've lost the. I think they've lost the license to the music now.
Whoops.
Probably because they didn't account for digital sales.
Yeah.
I don't think any of the Kingdom Hearts games are available digitally, aren't they?
They're available... No, they must be. Oh, they're HD remixes.
No, HD remix might be, but Birth by Sleep isn't on PSN. Like,
it's
the
in,
normal version.
It's in HD 2.5.
Yeah, but if I wanted to play it on the PSP version, I'd have to buy a physical copy. And actually buy a PSP.
Yeah. There is that small issue.
Because just it's a, like, it's weird that the PSP is this, like, build as this all-serving, like, all-kind of media device. Like, it does, like, oh, it has music, it does movies, it does... But it didn't account for going digital.
Well, it's old now.
It is old now, but it was, like... It was kind of at the point where, I suppose it was in the sort of transitionary period.
Mm.
Where it was, and then there's the PSP Go.
The what?
The PSP Go. Do you not remember the PSP Go?
No.
It's basically a PSP without a UMD slot.
So just for, like, digitally transferred stuff?
Yeah, only for digital stuff. It's pretty small, actually. So it's quite easy to carry around with you. I know a guy with two PSP Go's for some reason.
It's funny how things end up.
Well, I have two N-Gages in my room, so...
Yeah, the less said about that, the better. You've told that story already, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, god damn it, why do none of my dudes have enough damage to finish these people off?
Well, because, like, when the PSP Go was announced, it was a very controversial thing. Because it was like, well, how am I supposed to play all the games I bought physically?
Yeah.
Which is kind of fair.
Mm-hmm. That's still a problem we haven't sorted out the answer to.
It's like... I think
don't
most
kill
major...
Ramza. Sorry, say again.
I think at this point, most major Vita games are available digitally.
Yeah.
And it seems to be going that way for 3DS stuff as well. I think it's because it's mostly because most of what I've played recently has been like digital copies.
Mm.
Like, I don't think it's very often I actually get a physical copy of a video game anymore.
I generally try to, but...
Well, so I still... Because I still like getting PS2 games, so you can't get a digital one of those. And
yes.
Well, you could on other systems, but...
Sometimes.
But only certain games.
I mean, FF11, I suppose. I don't think you could ever get the whole of FF11 as a download, though.
Oh, my God. Well, no, because if you get it off of Steam... and buy all the expansions, it would still install it as one download.
Yeah, but I mean, it was... bits of FF11 were downloadable on PlayStation as well, on PS2.
Oh yeah, you needed the hard drive.
Mm-hmm. The most profitable Final Fantasy game. If Square themselves are to be believed.
Not the thing that had to be scrapped and relaunched.
That piece was so bad.
Yeah, I saw this piece and just... They have to see this.
It's the perfect example of everything that we work on. And this is that castle. This is allegedly the hardest part of the game coming up.
We'll find out.
We will find out. But I'm going to make a load of backup saves. One more for good measure.
I don't think that's gonna matter too much.
Save all the games!
You're just taking up space. That's all you're doing. You just need one.
No, I need enough that I don't accidentally save over them all.
Good point. I still used to be in the habit of just making one save.
Don't do that ever, particularly for a game you're streaming.
Oh, of course, yeah. But I think for certain, like, there are certain games where you only get one save slot. Like, both the Bravely games, you only get one save slot.
That's obnoxious.
But I don't think that game puts you in a position you can't escape from. Because it gives you the ability to turn off encounters and everything like that. I think Dragon Quest only gives one save slot.
Really? I mean, Dark Souls doesn't allow you to save in parallel, which that game really needs the ability to save in parallel.
Well, the way that game saves is like, it's just constantly autosaving.
Yes, quite.
And I think it having to rely on like a hard save system might not work as well, but I think that probably could work in both at the same time, because there are games that do that. I mean, Final Fantasy X on the PC is autosaves now.
Mm.
Which is pretty cool. They're really, they're super generous.
Mm. Enter these, right.
I wonder if they put an auto, because they put an autosave before every cutscene. It seems.
Hmm. But they won't let you won't let you skip the cutscenes.
Yeah. I'm wondering if they put an autosave before the final boss. Because that's like the only point where the non-skippable cutscenes really made a problem for me.
Because
that's the only point of the game where I was stuck for a long time.
Really? The final boss?
Yeah. Mm. That's about it. Do you say really as in, like, that boss is not too hard, or...?
I mean, I've only done it with, like, significantly over-leveled parties.
No, I didn't over-level the party that much. I kind of played the game... Well, I don't mean to say properly, because that's not a fair assessment of saying, well, I played this properly, like, unlike everyone else. But you know what I mean. Like, just sort of... without too much meandering.
Yeah. Whereas I meandered like mad, because it's a... I find it a very easy world to meander through.
Oh, it is. I actually, towards the end, where I got stuck on the final boss, I thought, you know what? I like this game, so I'm just going to meander. I'm just going to explore everything. Just explore the places, which I actually liked doing. More so than... I don't know. I kind of prefer it not having a world map kind of thing. I'm not a huge fan of like the reduced scale world map.
I think it's got its uses.
I feel like something like, I suppose it depends on the game I'm playing, but sometimes it feels like in some games I'm just going from location to location and the world map doesn't feel like it's serving a purpose.
Mm.
Like, there's no reason for me to be able to just, like, well, just go through the other locations to that location instead. Like...
Well, that was a sound effect.
It's a shame I couldn't hear that.
Just like a fucking kazoo sound. Sad kazoo at the end of this cutscene. Presumably to indicate the leader of the Knights Templar unleashing his magical powers and laying waste to the Lord of the Keep. This is so surreal. Right. I think that's my active save. Okay. First squad has two positions. Second squad has three. No, I don't want to save state again. There we go. So this is just a defeat all enemies level, with a really bad deployment. Wonderful. But it's alright, because the dude I'm really worried about has moved forwards.
Nice fire.
Can Ramza kill this guy in one turn? Hopefully. Yes, good. Fuck you. I killed you! Stop teleporting! What have we here? Probably leave you where you are, because you're isolated from everyone else. Wait a second. Oh my god. There is a knight in the moat in that gap. What?! Fuck this game and its camera angles! Oh my god, that's a dirty trick! Oh. Right, which character is supposed to be the one? There we go. I shall pelt him with things. If I can get range. I have this thing, Yagyu Darkroot. Might as well, I don't think it's good for anything else. Good news is, because he's in the moat, he probably won't be able to cause me very much grief for a little while. Bounce status, there we go. Rams is a little bit exposed here though. Okay, that's some long ranged archery. So not only is there a knight there in the moat, he's also got the water walking skill. Oh. Or float. One or the other. Ugh, damn. Wrong night.
Oh, the scores on this port were really high.
Scores on what?
The reviews for this version of the game were really high.
It's a pretty strong version. I think it's pretty good.
Yeah.
You have 238, you have 234...
It's mostly 9s and 10s.
Right, that's one of the archers dealt with.
Well, there's that Tactics Ogre game that has similar reviews as well on the PSP.
Tactics Ogre of all things.
It's probably the same team.
As this?
Yeah.
Huh.
Well, it's basically what they sort of Matsuno came out of. Well, not is the key members of Quest who developed Tactics Ogre basically went on to leave Square and leave Quest and then just go into Square, and they're all credited on the Final Fantasy Tactics games.
Right. Oh, damn.
Yeah, Tactics Ogre, as I understand, has very similar... Well, plays very similarly, but it's,
And if I was writing an advert for this game, I would not be stressing how it plays, because it's a screaming mess.
It was originally from the Super Famicom, so the camera's probably not going to be much better.
I dislike getting blocked twice on a 70% hit chance. Don't do me, you brat. Thank you.
Apparently Matsuno came back to Square just to work on the port of Tactics Ogre for the PSP.
When was that?
It was in... that came out in 2010 in Japan.
Really?
Yeah.
Blimey.
In the PSP version, you can go back to plot points where you make choices and see how the story unfolds differently.
It's quite sensible.
Because it is based off like basically Tactics Ogre is a spin-off of Ogre Battle.
Yeah.
So basically, Ogre Battle leads to Tactics Ogre, which leads to Final Fantasy Tactics. Mm-hmm. Which is... Yeah. But Ogre Battle is this weird real-time strategy thing.
Well, it was real-time even in the early games in that franchise.
In the Ogre Battle games, it was real-time from the start.
Really? Because they go back a long way.
It's about 93.
Yeah. Blimey. That's like pre-Command and Conquer.
Command and Conquer was that 95, wasn't it?
I think so.
Was it pre-Warcraft? Yeah, it's pre-Warcraft. And, yeah, Command and Conquer was 95. Warcraft was 94. When was Doom 2? 92.
Right, I now have 3 turns. I can probably. Best way of dealing with Doom, let the Blighted die and resurrect them. Unless that's my item user. No, it isn't. That's okay. Yeah. Well, that's my item user. What's he doing all the way over there? God damn it. I'm going to play it safe, because these bastards block a lot.
Tactics Ogre is the first game directed... No, Ogre Battle is the first game with Yasumi Matsuno credited as director. Somebody wants to say that properly.
It's fair enough.
She is currently apparently working on Unsung Story, whenever that's coming out. If that's coming out.
Yeah.
I hear the Odin Sphere remake's out next month.
The JRPG isn't dead because old ones keep getting resurrected.
But Odin Sphere. I don't know, like. My game doesn't. I know it's got all the RPG systems and stuff, like, it's very level based, but it feels. And it's quite long, but I don't know if, like. Because it feels like a character action game. I suppose that the genre sort of thing is a stupid thing to really think about in this regard.
There's certainly some pitfalls to doing so.
Yeah. I suppose it falls in the same appeal, so I'd probably put it in that crowd.
Yeah.
But it's very action gamey.
I win!
It has some very weird systems to it.
Wait, there was a... Instead of a victory animation, there was a dramatic flash of lightning. And now a dead dude is stumbling out. That's a really, really cheap dramatic flash of lightning effect. I love it. Still, that one was a bit on the tough side.
So apparently that's the hardest part of the game.
No. This is the... first battle of the hardest sequence in the game.
Oh.
The hardest fight in the game is the last fight of the sequence. But my sister isn't dead yet, so that's good. Don't. What are you doing? It really doesn't help that the death scream sound effect is a swanny whistle. Because I'm just... getting random squeaky noises from the corridor outside the cell.
That sort of noise, isn't it? Because it's made in an era, like this game was made in an era where kind of you were able to use like voice samples and small amounts of Redbook audio. So it's off a CD-based console.
Yep.
But I feel
it's got some very weak sound effects.
Well, this is the thing. Square took a long time to really adjust to the changes of sound technology. Because if you look at all the PlayStation Square games, the sound design, or the way the sound is done in those, there's very few like uses of Redbook audio. And most of the music is done through... the PlayStation hardware through like using samples that play over the hardware. I feel that, but that might be due to like space limitations because they use so much space with
FMV
sequences. Right. Even this one.
Yeah. I know, they could have done with redoing some of the sound effects for the PSP. Because the female death scream is ridiculous, and it really undercuts character deaths when they go, "Wee!"
I mean, plenty of games were starting to do voice in the PlayStation era, but it took, like, Square until the start of the PS2 to really...
Yeah.
I mean, there are Square games where characters are voiced at certain points in cutscenes before that.
Yeah, not many, though.
But it's used sparingly. Like, Xenogears has a few, doesn't it?
Yep, Xenogears has some.
I'm trying to think, are there actually, like, some fully voiced PlayStation RPGs?
The closest I can think of is Valkyrie Profile has quite a lot of voice, from what I've seen.
It's not fully voiced. It starts with quite a lot, but then it eventually just kind of transitions out of it, I think.
Yeah.
I don't like the voice acting in that game, though.
Well, it doesn't help that most of the characters are horrible as well.
Yeah. But... that game, the first, like, hour of that game is just introduction.
Yeah, I know. 334. Let's just try the direct approach. I think I ought to get two turns. If everything hits, that'll be enough. Everything is not hitting. Oh no, I'm fucked.
Woo!
Yeah, this is not going to work. This is the fight in question.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Is he doing magic attacks? Try once more. And then I will have to do some strategic rethinking.
Oh boy.
Uh-huh. Apparently there's an item you can equip that completely negates his magic attacks. Yeah, this isn't gonna work.
Oh dear.
Let's see whether I've got equipment that might help. This one. If not, I have all those safety saves.
All of those safety saves.
Uh-huh.
For safety.
I think I will actually, given the time and given that I don't seem to have what I need, I think I will call the stream there and go and do some research.
Alright.
But thanks for stopping by.
No problem.
And I shall see you next time.